God. And that's 2 Peter 3, verse 9. And here many times we have to ask the Lord, Lord, you know, thank you so much for being patient with me. Amen. Thank you so much for being patient with me. Instead of asking, Lord, give me patience. No, say thank you, Lord, for being patient with me. Amen. So many times we are stubborn. We want to do it our way. Amen. But thank you, Lord, for being so patient with me. Thank you, Lord, that you are that merciful God. You forgive me. And so many times, in fact, have you ever bought something that you had to put together? You know, some gadget that you maybe had to put together, like a shelf or something. You have to use a screwdriver. And you have to put it all together, and then you get the shelf or bookshelf or something, okay? Well, I'm the type, I have maybe a little bit of patience, but I will look at the picture. Oh, I can do it. And I will put that shelf together, and it's crooked. It's sitting like this. Ah, what happened? And so I asked Pastor God, I said, I don't know what happened. He goes, did you read the directions? He goes, you're just not patient enough, are you?
Yeah.
No. But I said, I tried to do it myself. And he says, no, that's not good enough. You got to read the book. You got to read the instructions. And that's the way it is with God. We try to do it ourselves. Okay, God, I can do it myself. I can do it myself. And then we mess up, don't we? And the Lord says, then we run to the Lord. Oh, you are my refuge. You are my refuge. He says, did you read the book? Did you read the book? Are you being obedient to me? Okay, Lord, thank you for being patient with me. Thank you, Lord. Amen? So we have to learn. In fact, I was just talking to someone this morning about, I was talking about ironing, remember? And I said, I'm very impatient. I don't like to iron. And iron clothes, okay? I don't like to iron. And so I was at my mother's place, and I said, oh, mother, I do not like to iron. And I'm doing this, trying to iron. And she goes, well, Lynette, if you would just slow down and be patient, you might could iron better. Okay, thank you. So I had to slow down and iron. But, you know, many times that's how we are. We want to just do it now, Lord. We want this fixed and that fixed, and we want it done now. But that's when we say, Lord, thank you for being patient with me. I know, Lord God, I'm not perfect, but thank you for being patient with me. And so he is a patient God. I'm sure he must smile down at you and I on some of the things we do in life. But he says, I'm patient with you. I love you. I still care. You tried it on your own, but you can't do it on your own. For we are weak, but he is strong.
Amen. Amen.
We are weak, but he is strong.
Amen.
Okay, number 11, he's an eternal God. He's a saving God. I give praise to you, Father, for the only God, our Savior. Jude chapter 25. To you the glory, majesty, and power, and authority. Wow, hallelujah. Jude 25.
To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever.
Amen. To you, Lord Jesus, be the glory, the majesty, the power, the authority through Jesus Christ our Lord, before all ages, now and forevermore. Amen. So I give you praise, Lord Jesus, for you are an eternal saving God. Thank you, Jesus. He's our Savior. He's our Savior. Amen? He's our Savior. Thank you, Lord. You're my Savior. Amen? I don't want to be left down in this earth, but I want to be saved. Amen? I want to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You are the Holy One. Amen. When you're praying and say, Lord, you are the Holy One. You are the Holy One. We worship you. We magnify you, Lord Jesus. Revelations 4, verse 8. Talking about the Holy One. Revelations 4, verse 8. Revelations 4, verse 8.
Each of the four living creatures had six wings and was covered with eyes all around. Even under his wings, day and night, they are never stopped saying, Holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was
and is to come. Woo! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Let's just stand right now. I'm not finished, but let's just stand. I just feel to just say, holy, 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 holy. Holy is our God. Holy is our God. Hallelujah. Holy Lord Jesus, you are holy. Thank you, Lord. You are the only Holy One, Lord God. You are so great. You are the eternal God. You are the patient God. Loves you and I. And I praise you, God, because you are a personable God. You are a person, God, who gives me the honor of knowing Him. Amen. It's such a great honor to know who Jesus Christ is. Amen. To know my hope, my life, my Savior. Hallelujah. Matthew 8, verse 11. Matthew 8, verse 11. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew 8, verse 11.
And I say unto you that many shall come from the east and west and shall sit down with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob in the kingdom of heaven.
Amen, amen. Inviting me to the feast at your kingdom table. How personal is that? Many times when we have friends over or we're visiting with friends, we all want to have a feast, don't we? Today we had a Thanksgiving with the usherettes. And it's always an enjoyable time, amen? And so here it was, it's talking about praising the Lord here. You are a personal God who gives the honor of knowing you personally. Even inviting me to the feast at your kingdom's table with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Ooh, that's exciting to know. Amen? Amen. Number 14, he's a giving God. Number 14, a giving God. Many times we choose who we want to give to, don't we?
Amen.
We choose. That's our choice. But God, He gives to everyone. Amen. He gives to all. Amen. John 3:16. For God's, go ahead, recite it, all of us. Whosoever believeth in Him shall not
perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen. Hallelujah. So He is a giving God. All praise and honor be yours, O God. Because you are a generous God who did not even stop short of giving to us salvation. Amen? Because he's a giving God. He could have chosen, say, just the rich or just the poor. But he chose all of us. Amen? He's a giving God. He says, I do not just have salvation for the poor, but he says, I have salvation for all of you. For all of us. We don't have to be rich, poor, fat, skinny. We don't have any requirements. God says, I give to you salvation. I give my gift unto you. In you being obedient to his word. Amen. Baptized in his precious name. Receive the gift of his Holy Ghost. And all of these things shall, all these blessings will be added unto your life. Okay? Number 15, he is a provider God. He provides for us. And I praise you today, Lord, as my Jehovah Jireh. The Lord will provide for me. Amen? And the Lord is my shepherd, who will shepherd me and guide me in the paths of righteousness for your name's sake. Amen. Hallelujah. So he is a provider. He provides for every one of us. Now, he does not just choose one, but he provides for all of us. And he's also, the scripture for that is 2 Corinthians 9, verse 8. 2 Corinthians 9, verse 8. He is our provider. Does anyone have that? 2 Corinthians 9, verse 8. Amen. He provides for all of us. Number 16. God, my shepherd. God, my shepherd. I bless your name, Lord. I praise you as my shepherd. The Lord, my shepherd. Who shepherds over me. Amen. Psalms 23, verse 1 to 3. The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
Amen. Yes, amen. We've gone past three. So, God, he is my shepherd. Amen. He watches over me just like the shepherd watches over the sheep. And what have you ever seen them watching over? And my grandfathers were farmers. And so I would see that they didn't really have sheep. They had cows and pigs and other things. But I would see, my grandfather was like a shepherd, really, you know, because he was watching over all of them. When he would see the storm coming, he would make sure they got into the barn. Yeah. Amen. When he seen they were hungry, he made sure they had food. Yeah. Amen. Of course, animals are always hungry. But I think, you know, that it's so beautiful how our God, he is our shepherd.
Amen.
When he sees that we are hungry, he feeds us. Amen?
Amen.
He feeds us through the preaching of the word. Amen. He is helping us. And when we are in trouble, when we feel troubles coming our way, when we feel a storm is coming our way, he shepherds us. He helps us. He comforts us. Amen? Our Heavenly Father comforts us. And he knows when those storms are coming. And so he says, I will never give you more.